Okay, well, let's try this again. This is Nathan P. Butler. This is my channel in gearing up for some more Star Wars content, of course, for the channel, which is what the bulk of the channel's content is, which will include, of course, the Star Wars X-Wing VR mission, Rogue One themed from Battlefront. We're looking at some PlayStation VR scenarios here because one of the questions I get the most is whether or not it's going to be worth it. And so far, I would say absolutely yes. I had a chance to stream some here of Batman Arkham VR and some of, let's see, what was the next thing? Until Dawn, Rush of Blood. Played a little bit of Rigs in a couple of streams, got motion sick about 20 minutes into Rigs and had to stop the scenario and then pick it up later as sort of a part two. Simulation sickness is a real thing, and it's going to be difficult to get yourself acclimated in some cases to some of these scenarios in the gameplay. I certainly am having some trouble with some, but even here on the second day, being able to play a little bit of Rigs, it wasn't quite as bad as the first time. I've also played a bit of Eve Valkyrie, which I haven't streamed yet. I'll be streaming that later tonight if this one doesn't wind up making me feel a little woozy. But we're checking out here what is thought of as sort of like the demo disc, which isn't really a demo disc because there is a demo disc. PlayStation VR Worlds. Five different games essentially built into one. I'm playing right now with a DualShock 4, although I'm assuming you can't see them. I'm sort of leaning down to get to it. Yeah, I've got my Move motion controller kind of waving in front of my face right now, and it's not showing it, so yeah, won't be doing that. So we have Danger Ball, we have the London Heist, we have VR Luge, Scavenger's Oddyssey, which is similar to Eve in the sense that it's a space situation, and Ocean Descent. This is the one I've been the most psyched about. I've always loved the idea of places in the world that we can't really get to as easily. So, you know, the animals we don't usually see, just things that a surface dweller in the middle of a freaking urban setting, or even in the Midwestern setting as I grew up, wouldn't necessarily get to see much. So, figured this would be pretty cool. Can be played seated or standing, in this case, and controlled with the VR headset. Nice that they tell you that, because I'm assuming I'll be able to bust out the Move controllers for London Heist. But let's check out Ocean Descent. And yes, I'm in like a... turning all the way around here. In like a... almost feels like an old school, almost Renaissance era or Roman style building here. Which acts as your starting point. There's a cool little animated sequence you go into when you first sign into the game that goes to some of the different environments, like this water environment here for Ocean Descent. Journey all the way to the ocean bed and experience a perilous story. Watch out for the shark. We got shark encounter, wildlife tour, and core. Okay, cool. So there's three different ones. Let's go with... oh, everybody wants to see sharks, right? Shark encounter. Right, recentering, hold options to recenter yourself in the game world. That is always the case in these games. If you are using a Move controller, you're going to be able to recenter using the start button, which is the equivalent of the new options button for the PlayStation 4. Because the Move controllers did come out in the PS3 era originally. Oh, cool. Shark tank kind of thing going on here.
Okay, rookie, this is a recon dive. I've got intel from my guy Connor that there was a lot of offshore salvage recorded in this area. Lots of surface debris.
I feel like I need to stand up for this one.
The effort.
Ooh, fishies!
I'm sensing it could be something big.
Right up in my grill.
No one's been exactly authorized to run salvage operations in these waters, so we gotta act fast.
Cool.
Rookie, I'm sending you down with the recovery drones. They'll grab anything that isn't nailed down. I just need you, eyes on, to assess if there's anything of value once we hit bottom.
Ah! Shit! If I scared them, or if they scared me?
It's unknown waters down there, but we'll be with you every step of the way.
I'm doing this seated, by the way. I've got the move motion controls down near my feet so I can more easily get to them when the time comes.
Hey,
so I'm not
JJ,
really walking around.
Check?
Roger that. All systems A-okay, Cal.
I kind of want to.
Link to salver suit in 3, 2, 1. Showtime. Scopes are live and on screen.
Cool. and very immersive. And I guess this makes perfect sense because the thing you really get... One of the things you really kind of get with the headset on is a feeling almost like you're wearing goggles. It's 100 degrees of vision.
We may be able to ID what's going on from
but then you can turn it 360 degrees.
Interesting to your comms unit. Next floor,
if I'm underwater, of course I'll need goggles or something. So it's very much a perfect fit. I've also, for what it's worth, got the lights turned off or turned low. So even the little bit of light that escapes in, like around your cheekbones, is pretty minimal at this point for me. Oh, crab! Spent too much time around the Clintons, caught crabs.
Something big definitely went down here.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman. Alright, hell I did. And I enjoyed it.
But hey, you got JJ on the winch, and he's the best in the business.
JJ's on the winch? JJ Abrams? Love the Force Awakens, man!
We got company coming your way.
And trekking.
We're getting multiple pings on the scopes.
Into darkness. Cool. These manta rays seem freaking huge. I guess that's what they are. Oh! I've got a controller up to the side. Doesn't actually do anything. Nothing is controller-based at this point. It's all basically me looking with my head. Thing is damn near huge. Woo! Thing feels like it's full width. Could be like the width of my car. Or even the length of the car, almost. That's crazy. And I'm assuming these are meant to be similar to real-life sizes. Music pretty subdued at this point. Got a bucket in case I throw up. Unfortunately, it's a virtual bucket. So it only works if I throw up virtually. Not gonna help me with rigs.
Lots more debris. Something big definitely went down here. And it looks recent, too. Connor, where the hell have you sent me this time?
Big sucker.
Whoa, the seismometer's just lit up for a moment, Cal. Something's moving around down there.
So I'm getting close to the surface, though. Whoop! What's up, Robbie the robot? Cool. Under the sea.
Okay, you may have to breathe in. It's gonna be a tight fit. Keep your eyes open.
It's just cause we are with PlayStation VR. Under the sea.
JJ, steady on that winch. This is seriously risky, but it's the quickest way down.
Oh, hey, yeah, because that's... Oh! In the words of Angry Joe, you fucked it up!
Ooh. Let's go easy on that winch.
Glowing jellyfish.
Slow it down.
I know that's not the sound of cats underwater. Those are cats in real life, if you can hear them. That'd be kind of trippy if you were starting to hear, like, weird hallucination-type sounds down here, though. So where's the light? I guess it's the light supposed to be coming just from the jellyfish, because you can still sort of see around you. Right, so if I hit one of these, it's gonna go blomp, 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 and I'm gonna get like half the size of normal. Which it sucks, I'm already like 5'5", so hey. No Mario-ing here. It's interesting, you look down, I mean, there's no... A lot of these games give you a virtual body when you're standing there, whether we're talking about rigs or we're talking about Eve Valkyrie or Gunjack. Not in this case. That is when I tried also Eve Gunjack. Let's take a look at
it.
Oh, more crabs.
Any minute we'll be clear of the cave.
JJ, can you get the cage lights back?
Yeah, JJ.
That's better.
Don't be a dick, JJ.
What? Where in the hell did that come from?
I'm gonna say human made.
Connor was so damn cagey. JJ, any ideas on the origin of that vessel?
Okay, you can lean forward.
There's no signature coming from her, and no report of anything at large going down in this sector.
Huh.
Guess we better take a damn good look at her then.
Nice.
Well, she's definitely military.
Yes, I did just stand up to look down.
This is recent.
So screw it, I guess I'll stand up. I just don't want to trip over anything.
Whoa, Geiger counter just lit up, Cal.
Okay, kill the damn toxin.
Okay, so nuclear sub?
Rookie, this is really hot. We haven't got a lot of time, but your suit will keep you safe for a while.
That's hot.
So we finally hit the jackpot, and she's a damn nuclear sub with no known origin. Great. Just great. Looks like Connor's got us doing his dirty work. Okay, Rookie, let's hustle and get as much intel as we can on this wreck. I'm not walking away with nothing.
I'm gonna recenter here and see if this...
How are we doing at max dive time?
Yep, there we go. Okay, it makes it more like I'm standing. Because I am standing. It recentered that main opening in the cage so that I can look through it.
Okay, keep an eye out for falling debris. We don't have a lot of time.
Uh-oh.
Keep your eyes...
Rocks and shit!
The drones will take care of the rest.
I'm getting a strong heat signature off something down there. Could be the radiation source.
It's weird. If you look just right, it almost feels like you're floating just a little. It's not as heavy a sensation of movement like what you get with Until Dawn Rush of Blood, where you're on the roller coaster part. And it's certainly nowhere near as disorienting as when you control your own movements with something like rigs. But it doesn't feel as static as standing still in Batman Arkham VR either. There's a subtle sense of motion. Connor wanted us to find Jesus?
We need whatever it is in one piece. Let's get it topside and see what we have. I got a feeling we're not the only ones after that crate.
Cute.
Hold on. We're picking up something large moving towards you.
Oh, that'd be that big-ass shark over there. As I try not to fall back into the chair. I'm trying. Stop smacking my cage. Thinking that whole 360 degree thing, unless I'm gonna turn around, I gotta swing around with my head. You are ugly! Hey, he just took my. Air thing. To be fair, it did look kind of like a roll of Mentos the Fresh Maker. So he's like, Alright, so. Raised up. Where'd the shark go? JJ is a misogynist and is like, you're the winch, winch! At which point she slaps him with a harassment lawsuit. You know, if that hit the shark.
Get out of there, damn it! Get them out of there!
Them? Come on, me and the robots? You should be caring about me, not the robots, yo. That is a long freaking shark. And these little things here, this does not look big enough to actually protect the person. Uh-oh. Good thing I wasn't sitting down. Pipe would have poked me in the... Yep. Damn. I think I know people who would absolutely freak at this point. Okay. You know. You see, like, the debris floating in front of your face, which is pretty sweet.
Damn it. What's going on down there?
So, could I, like, jump off of here, yo? What's going on? Dinner for one. Made of one. Kind of the reverse of ordering the fillet of fish. Somewhere out there, there's a joke of we're gonna need a bigger boat, but I'm not even sure we're gonna need a bigger boat so much as we're just gonna need a, you know, boat. Instead of a fucking cage! Except this shark doesn't seem to be too smart. He doesn't actually go for, you know, the giant gaping hole and try to eat me. Though maybe he will. But I do say that that is one point that breaks the immersion, actually. As crazy as it is, him smacking it and the shifting and everything, you don't have that sensation to go along with the shaking of it. So it actually almost knocks you out of the scenario. Bonk.
Whoa.
You wanna get rocked?
Trouble. Just another day in the office, eh?
Shut the fuck up and get me out of here.
I don't think I can call you rookie anymore.
Damn straight. Whew, hell of a first dive, kid. Cal, radar just picked up something inbound on our heading.
Really?
Looks like we've got company. And I have a feeling we have what they're looking for. Connor, what have you gotten me into?
I don't know! What has he gotten you into? And scene. Sweet. That's pretty cool. The atmospheric immersion is just... It's that weird thing where you're kind of like, well, you know you're not in water. You know you're not encumbered by a suit. You know you're not being rattled around when the cage is being rattled around. I'd almost think that'd be something where if you're sitting, it would feel more... obvious, which is what I was trying to do in the first place, but very cool visuals. They try to keep the draw distances for the things that you need to see in detail relatively short, so it looks nice. The best way I can describe, by the way, somebody asked me earlier, when you're wearing the headset, people talk about it being blurry or being lower resolution. What exactly is it? I would argue it's not particularly blurry per se, depending on the scenario. Like rigs can look kind of blurry, but not quite as much when I was playing it today. So that may have just been my eyes needing to get used to it again. But that said, I would say that it almost feels like it's like trying to watch something through a very fine screen door. A screen door that is so fine you can just barely see it, but when you try to focus on the pattern of the screen itself, rather than what you are seeing beyond that screen, then it becomes noticeable, if that makes any sense. You're noticing the resolution, I guess, in a sense of the OLED screen, the 1920 by RGB by 1080 OLED screen split into the 960 RGB 1080 for one eye and the other, as it is then put into the stereoscopic 3D. Lots of things going on with the headset. Okay. I know, I'm probably making you sick. I'm like, boom, 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 boom. I tend to talk and emote and move my hands a lot, even if you can't see them, which is probably something you noticed in any of the other videos on the stream here. So let's, or on the channel. Let's check out, this one I've been really interested in trying out because I want to know if the motions feel is there. So let's check out VR Luge. Feel the exhilaration of an illegal street race as you speed downhill weaving through traffic. Post your best times to online leaderboards. Control with a VR headset. So, just like the ocean descent thing here as far as that goes. Tour and time trial. Let's go with, I guess I'll sit down here and recenter it. There we go. I don't know if you can see that it's recentering or not. But it moved the ball down. As I sat down, it moves the ball, so it's kind of more like around my chest level. Let's do the tour! So no motion sickness yet, by the way, after that. Which you wouldn't expect there to be motion sickness, given that that was a somewhat tame scenario, more about... kind of like Arkham VR, really. Where basically you're standing in a set location, or sitting in a set location, looking around to check out the environment. Okay, so that's all it's telling me is, lean your head! I'll stretch my legs out here so it feels a little more lugey. Gotta be careful with that. Luge, not loogie. It doesn't feel like I'm spitting. There are a lot more of these, like, blank screen moments. I think part of it is meant to sort of break apart the crazy visuals. La la la. Starting time, prepare for launch. Okay. All of a sudden, I became General Charles Lee in Hamilton. Whoa! Oh, gotta go up the rope! Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Now, this really does... You can really kind of feel the graphical limitations on this. The further away the draw distance gets on something... Oh, underneath the truck, I guess is what that was. Oh, another one. But there's a VR sensation for having the skin peeled off your face. Oh, is this a jump? Woo! Oh. Yeah, but there's not like a penalty really for running into stuff. It's more just like the sensation of gliding and getting you used to the idea that you can control... Oh, under the car. That you can control your stuff with your head. Oh. It's just tilt, right? Okay. I'm actually kind of leaning back. Maybe I need to sit up and just tilt my... There we go. Yeah, if I just sit up and tilt my head, it's not quite as crazy. Whoa, shit! Okay, I'd rather go under that car than go underneath the truck, though I probably should have rather gone under the truck. Since semi-trucks tend to sit up higher. Or trailer trucks, whatever you call them. Which way am I going? Oh, nutsack. Huh. Interesting. Run number two. Ooh, pretty. Can't really look at the sights that much, though. Oh, because as you tilt your head, it's gonna recognize the movements. Yeah, I'm very surprised at this. From a graphical perspective, this really seems like a downgrade graphic. Whoa! Shit. Downgrade graphically from the other PSVR games I've played so far. Damn it. I'm a human pinball. Hey, that wasn't pretty bad. Or that wasn't too bad. And oh! So is this essentially the same track, just a different time of day? Whoop, whoop. Ah. Driving by all the trees and the lodges, I'm thinking, is Alan Wake staying anywhere near here? Damn. Kind of like once you lose control briefly, you're basically right... You're right back in the mess, as Maz Kanata might say. Oh, under the car. I just got a little tough to see with all those lights. And done. Those nighttime lights made it a little difficult to follow where I was going. Failed! Your mama. Okay, cool. Let's try one of the other modes, given the fact that there are five, and now we've tried two. Kind of cool, relatively limited. I had a lot of people saying that that was the mode on this that you should experience more discomfort, the simulation sickness thing, because of all the rapid movement. I didn't actually feel it. I didn't get made to feel sick at all with that. My eyes feel a little dry, but that's it. I'll try Danger Ball. That's what she said. Enter the sporting event of the future. Master your skills and destroy your rivals. Control with the VR headset. Aye. Face off against a series of rivals over six rounds to win the Danger Ball Championship. Score attack, quick play, tournament. Let's just do quick play. I have no idea. We'll do random. Easy to start with, since I don't know what the f*** I'm doing. Ooh. Recentering, got it. All right, moving. Turn your head to move the paddle. The paddle is your face. Flick the paddle sideways for a curve shot. Okay. Flick your head forward for a smash shot. So this is like that Headmaster game, essentially, which they say is like a soccer-ish thing. Okay. Whoa. Okay. So I'm in a box. Greetings, programs! Clue, 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 clue. Oh, there I am. Oh! Oh, gotta stand up for this shit. And duck. This is pretty good for getting you a sense of how the... Oh, I missed it. How the spatial awareness works. That's pretty cool. Hey, no fair. 5-5, asshole. Recenter. Up! Up. Okay, it paused. I was trying to recenter. And it did it again. Alright, whatever. Okay. Oh, and it went right in my face. I tried to slap it and I missed it. You almost need to hold the headset for this. Ooh, I may have to jump, like... Okay, no, I can just look way up. Alright, I'm thinking I gotta, like, put my whole body next to the ball. I don't, I just gotta swing my head far enough in the direction to control it. So that where I'm looking, essentially, is where this thing is. Okay, that makes more sense. Oh, I tried to slap it and I missed it. Your game has been derezzed, cause you suck. Now, can I recenter? Of course I can't. It's gonna send me to the pause menu again. Oh, no. You lose! Alright, let's try this shit again. Let's try this shit one more time! Cause it's kinda neat. I thought this was gonna be the most boring of the modes on this one. I was kinda like, oh yeah, this is gonna be so fun. Ooh, but actually it's kinda cool. What happens when you play Pong with your face? It actually reminds me, for those of you who are like old school gamers like I am from like back in the 80s, like early 80s to mid 80s, like my first game system was a Nintendo Entertainment System, the original. And you know, I have family who had like my grandmother had a Pong machine, for God's sake. But I think about this and I'm thinking in terms of like, it reminds me of Super Glove Ball with the Power Glove, right? It's so bad. Oh, I scored! Sweet. I feel like I need to sit my controller down. Ah, damn it, because I'm not using it. So I'm just going to sit it behind me on the chair. So I'm hands-free right now. Head only. Ah, I missed it. Oh, got one there. Okay. Yeah, it reminds me a lot of Super Glove Ball. as Super Glove Ball was where you would use the power glove to throw a ball and break bricks on the opposite wall, and it was like a maze. So, not entirely like this. It just reminds me of it because of the whole aspect of using, oh wow, you can destroy the ground. Except in this case, your goal is not to destroy the ground, apparently, I would assume. Eat it. Granted, it was easy, though. 5-2. I didn't even notice the score was down there. Yeah! Yeah, that's right. That's right. Anyway. Okay, now I gotta make sure I don't sit on my controller so I can press X to continue and sit my butt back down. That was pretty sweet. I like that. Okay, so that's the favorite so far. It even beats The Ocean Descent, which I would never have expected. It's fairly straightforward, but it's pretty freaking fun. I love the sci-fi-ish Tron feel of it. Alright, so we got London Heist and we got Scavenger's Oddyssey. Wait, there we go. Plug into an all-terrain alien craft, explore a dangerous nebula, and recover a mysterious artifact. Contains 360-degree movement, played with wireless controller. Okay. Ooh, that's... Okay, that's pretty sweet. Oh! Ha ha! Alright, that was awesome. I can... smack the planet with my controller. Which I'm assuming I guess I could do with all these, right? Nice. Oh, and it's like it's made of water. Okay, okay. That's the one I just saw. VR Luge, whoa. Vroom, vroom. Sweet. London Heist. Chink, it's like a jewel. Whoa. And Danger Ball. Oh, that is... sweet. Talking about interactive menu situations. Awesome. Okay, Scavenger's Oddyssey. Let's do it. Oh. I literally just leaned forward with my hand to try to push the thing away. Not the hand that had the controller in it that's being tracked because of the light with the camera. Derp! Plug in your craft and escape the Doom dropship. Okay, so you got three scenarios there, and who knows how many for the second one. Cool. Piss off. Let's see, recentering. Of course, we already know that. Check. Craft movement. Use the left and right sticks. This might give me a little bit of that simulation sickness. Hold L1 to sprint forward. Turn your head to aim. So it's like rigs in that sense. Press R2 to fire. Hold L2 and look for landing point. Release or jump to a landing point. Energy grapple. Hold R1 to grab onto an object. Hold R1 launcher to build launcher power. Release R1 to launch it. Well, shit, that's not a whole lot to try to remember all of a sudden. Bring it!
For too long you have traveled alone, Pilgrim. Soon you will.
It's John Wayne writing.
You traveled alone, Pilgrim.
Forbidden bounce. Nav point reached. Dropship slowing to sublight speeds. Cryogenic systems disengaged. Initiating suspended animation.
Here's
revival
my funky
protocols.
Funky body.
Initiate pilot AI symbiosis. Preparing plug-in. Merging of pilot and craft AI.
Alright, well if it's a plug-in, make sure it's not a QuickTime plug-in. That shit never works. Oh, that's kind of neat. Wiring me into the ship. Oh, and notice I've got four fingers on each hand.
DNA for identification.
I'm some kind of creepy
species,
alien.
68% median, 32% race unknown. Classification, underbreed.
Wait, Nara, wait.
169 QR. Status, fugitive anarchist.
I'm a big percentage of one species and you don't know my other species, which means that, like, my mama got it on with an alien.
Looks like we're really going looting in the Forbidden Belt.
No wonder I'm an anarchist.
By all reports, the artifact we're hunting is believed to be here. Every damn lead we follow points to this perilous location.
Okay.
Our dealers all lined
your
up
alien feet.
More credit than we'd ever see in 100 life cycles. All we gotta do is find it.
Behind me.
Request dropship release.
360 degrees, but
prepare to disembark on landing.
Let's do this. Uh-oh.
Whoa! Dropship's taking damage. Damn it. The clamp's release mechanism's fused solid. We're gonna have to shoot our way out.
Okay.
Bring
oh, there we go.
Online. Take out those consoles.
Very Riggs-esque. Aiming with the gun turrets based on head position.
You got Scavenger craft navigation waypoint subsystems online.
Whatever you say, babe.
Follow it to the airlock.
Okay.
Move faster by holding L1 to sprint forwards.
Standard first-person shooter controls.
The ship's not gonna hold together for much longer. Airlock doors have taken a hit. We're sealed in.
Not
use
for
the
long.
Energy grapple to pull the emergency bolts off the door.
Okay, and that is R1. This energy grapple presented by Riz.
Cargo base integrity's been compromised. We're at 0G. Brace yourself, Scavenger.
Woo! Oh, I'm in a mech. That must be what that little thing was. I'm in
like
a
one-way trip.
Bug mech. Whoa! Okay, yeah. Very Eve feeling.
Hold
Eve
on.
Valkyrie.
It's gonna be tight, but we're going right through that wreck.
It's gonna be tight, but we're going through the thing that looks like an anus!
Surely not all these craft were just
probably not intended double entendre, but... Nice.
We're taking hits. Shields down to 75%.
I can't control anything, by the way, right now.
Shields critical. We need a safe landing spot. Down to 26%.
Pretty low res, though, as I'm
Land
looking at the stuff that I'm seeing here. Like eye disorienting, Riggs-esque lower res.
Shields holding. Surface contact in 5, 4.
Decent frame rate, though.
2, 1.
I realize that I really should have turned the fan on before I started playing.
Forbidden belt reached. Not quite what we had in mind. Shields recharged. Now at 100%. All systems are go. Follow the waypoint while I try to get a read on the artifact. Whoa. What is that? It's not like anything we've ever seen. Midian crazies talk of an anomaly at the center of the belt.
Ooh.
Identifying a huge energy source. It's emanating from the horizon point.
Pilgrim.
Sensing disruption to the pilot AI symbiotic link.
What's up, Pilgrim?
Stay with me, Scavenger.
In the beginning, there was darkness.
Whoa! Keep your hyperspace out of my face.
In the darkness, we built a gateway so that we could enter and lay the seeds of a new universe.
Called the Stargate? Shapa
Eye?
Halo?
And worshipped it as their creator.
Doctor Who Gallifreyan language?
Our children forgot about us. But we did not forget about them.
Oh, cat's acting crazy.
I did not forget about you, Pilgrim.
Why, thank you, lady.
Oh, I thought I lost you. You were totally out for the count. Scanning for source of rogue transmission. It must be the remnants of some crazy's data log transmitting from one of the wrecks. Scavenger, I'm updating navigation waypoint subsystems. Destination, Monolith.
All right.
Okay, we're gonna need to get ourselves across these asteroids. Activating quadrupedal jump motors. Look at the location you want to jump to, and hold down L2 to engage jump systems. If we can jump there, you'll see a green arrow.
Oliver Queen? Cool. Alright, though I will... Because I'm just trying to try this out... I'm gonna jump out here. Get out of my way. Can't see it. I'm gonna hear the cats getting into something. Okay, awesome. Alright, so London Heist is the last one on. Get out of my way! Trying to make sure we see all of these. Ooh, step into London's criminal underworld with a gritty gangster thriller, play with two motion controllers or a wireless controller. Alright, so I need to get my motion controller, so I need to move this out from my eyes for just a second. Okay, make sure those. Oh, my. I need to switch my controllers momentarily. Okay, they are still both active, it said. It's just that they're not ready. So I'm gonna pop one of these each onto each wrist. I apologize if you just went to that blue screen. It gets a little weird. There we go. Okay, you can stop with the notification blings now. Alright, so I got those. I need to pick up my... Yep, as my head goes into it. Pick up my controller so I can switch. Control method two motion controllers. My balls are now lit up. Gotta lean down and put down the controller. Any button on the controller in your right hand. Any button on the controller in your left hand. Hold down triggers and move the controller to navigate the menus. Like always, press X to select. X is... There we go, that one. Learn how to interact with objects and weapons before you become a gangster in this short tutorial. Let's try the tutorial. It's not actually activating. I'm like reaching forward to punch that ball and it's not doing anything. Again, start is the same as options because this was designed in the PS3 era. Pick them out, hold the T button or the trigger button to pick them up. So very much like Batman, shooting is the trigger button. Reload. What? Just, okay, well that's interesting. All right, this will be cool. Let's give it a shot. Pick up the can. Okay, there we go. Two motion controllers, one for each hand, rotating, tracking, just like Batman. Ugh!
Oh, nice.
Okay. Oh, that's sweet. Yeah, and you are actually holding it the way that you would hold a gun. It's not like with Arkham where it's like you're pointing the ball like this, or even like to a degree the way that you're playing Until Dawn, Rush of Blood, where it's like the ball that's pointing, where you'd be holding it more like this. Instead, you're actually holding it with your hand at the angle that the... That's so cool, I can show you this shit. At the angle of the grip. That is awesome. Drop the gun in the tray. Okay. Tutorial complete! Alright, well, that was not difficult. Alright, so hold the trigger and click down. Oh, but it's... There you go. Just a wee bit finicky. Two motion controllers. I just did this. Right hand, left hand. Gotcha. Story. Prologue. Gangster or foot soldier?
Living in a gangster's paradise. Man spending most his time in the VR world. Living in a gangster's paradise.
Look at the situation they got me facing. I can't live a normal life. I was raised on VR.
Anyway.
So I gotta be down with PlayStation. Too much VR watching got me nauseated.
Anyway. Exit. Barrels and shit.
Okay.
Frank. Here we got a problem. I think we got a faith on board. Serena's gone.
Hello?
Thieving bastard pulled a switch.
Hello?
She's just fucking right up. No. No, Frank. I don't know where she is. And I'm worried.
I want to know what my cat is messing with. Honestly. Oh, camera. Sorry, I'm leaving my... Okay, yeah, she's playing with a receipt. I'm good. Thought I was going to have to stop for a second.
Yeah. Okay.
Turn on a light, you big, ugly mother...
Fancy your chances, did ya?
There are some lights.
Glad you fancy your chances now, eh?
How do I fancy them?
I'd say they're pretty fucking limited, wouldn't you?
I can't.
The plan was simple. Go in quietly, get Serena, and take her to Frank. Oh no, you had to do a little fucking disappearing act. Why are you? Some sort of fucking magician?
Well, I do have floating hands.
I tell you what. I've got a little magic trick of my own I'd like to show you. I think he's gonna fucking love this one. Yeah. Watch. Ta-da!
That was weird. Oh, you got a revolver. Ain't too special.
Now the only question I got for you is...
Oh, he's tracking my head. Somebody invited Green Day. So I guess I shouldn't be done. I'm probably making those who are watching it like... La Bird and Butcher, yesterday. 7:03 p.m. I was not expecting saxophone in one of these games. Just saying. Assuming that's what that is. I used to play alto sax back in the day, so... Oh, well... Okay. Well, isn't this cozy? This is cozy. All right.
Private meeting. The door stays shut.
Oh, okay. That's crazy.
French Tony's dead.
I'm sorry.
I had to let him go.
Oh, you did it. So you're basically a dick.
Talking to the Russians. Victor fucking Kozlov and his Russian fucking money.
Russian fucking money? He was a hoe?
My old man knew the score. He always say, you can't make money from a prison cell or a coffin. He's spot on.
All right.
This Russian lot ain't got a clue.
Okay, this is...
to shoot everyone else.
Pretty cool.
Killing people over nothing. Well, even a bent copper can't
pick up this up.
That, they'll get us all banged up.
Deborah.
You know how you bring down a man like Kozlov? You make him look a mug. Do that, and he'll come at you so loud, so strong, that if the old Bill don't kill him, his own people will. And that's why, tonight, we are going to help ourselves to the one Oink. Thing he cares about the most.
His wife?
His beloved diamond.
That too.
Serena.
Are you sure it's not his wife?
You'll need these. Mobile phone. It's clean. Ditch it when you're done.
Okay, it's Sony. Good. If it was a Samsung Galaxy, that thing was going to explode on me. All right.
Keeps your hands free.
Oh, cool. I put it in my ear. I think you that or I just dropped it on the floor. Woo, baby!
For the job, not the horses.
Well, now I got enough to buy an Oculus Rift.
I've made sure the alarms are switched off.
My bad.
So all you've got to do is walk in, get the diamond,
yep,
and
fell
walk
on the floor.
Out again. Easy. Something else I want to talk to you about. It's about the business.
All right.
Now, there's a lot riding on this. A lot for you, personally. I've known you for...
Uh-oh.
Darling, who's up for a Russian party?
Oh, I said no one was allowed up
yeah,
here.
Yeah, well, I ain't no one, am I, Frank? I've got the security passes you asked for. Those boys done them on a computer.
Thanks, Mickey.
Now, they are the fucking bollocks.
We're talking.
Right. Okay, what are we talking about?
What are you, the old Bill? It's none of your fucking business.
Now, wait, where'd I go?
A fan round.
Yeah. All right, Frank.
Weird. I'm curious.
As I was saying.
I can throw it from hand to hand if I'm careful.
You was little.
Nice.
You've been part of the family since I took you in.
Back
that's what
up.
I see you as. Family. Now, I'm looking to take more of a back seat. Enjoy some of what we've built up over the years.
I feel you.
Yeah, give us a light.
Oh, I was about to grab it and light it for him.
Now, I love Mickey, but he can barely take a shit on his own, let alone run this lot. You, on the other hand, have got what it takes, when the time comes, to keep this little kingdom out of the hands of men like Kozlov. But you've got to earn it.
All right.
You know what this is? This...
Your diary?
It's the old business, trapped between the pages of a little black book. You pull this off tonight... It's all yours. Hey, go on, piss off.
Now you're telling me to piss off. Huh, okay. Smoky. East London lockup. 6:39 a.m. A cat playing with that piece of paper is driving me insane. Oh, and here we are again. May I? No, I guess not. You're gonna fucking kill me. Okay.
What you looking at? You got some stones looking me in the eye?
Eat it. Is this the same earthquake that caused the things to fall down when I was up with the shark? Be honest. You prick!
You and me are gonna play a little game. And the game is called, Where's Serena? I bet you thought you'd be halfway around the world by now. But you're here. With me. And we're all wondering if you know where she is.
Fire. Fire. Nope.
I'm gonna bring you into crack, you little piece of shit! I don't give a monkey's fuck what Frank thinks about you! I don't trust you! And you know why? Because there's only two people that could have taken Serena today. You or me! And it weren't fucking me! Now you two, where were the... Fuck's sake!
Frank.
It's your fantasy soccer shit, isn't it? Or football.
It's your lucky day. He wants to talk to you.
Ah, well. Hello?
Right. I understand we have a little dilemma. Forget Mickey for a minute. Just tell me, in your own words, exactly what happened.
Well, okay then. What happened? Okay, I'm right, sitting at a desk now.
I can see ya. Now find that fucking diamond. Frank sorted the alarm, so I'll give you a heads up if I see anyone coming.
Got a key.
Is that a key? Fan-fucking-tastic. See if you can find what it's for. That code must be in somewhere. Keep looking.
Okay, I'm gonna have to, like, actually get up and look. Anything else in there? Nope. Okay. Oh, there's a light. Cool. Oh, that's weird. Can I open the clock? It just feels like I could grab the clock, but I guess I can't. Unless I'm supposed to change something on it.
Get down.
That's gonna get down. Dude, I got the... Mother... Guard can suck it. I'll take that guard. Let's see where the guard went, but okay. Alright, so I've got the... Well, okay, but I don't know what I'm doing. It's not gonna do me any good. I don't bloody know what I'm doing. Well, I don't really know what I'm doing. What am I playing at? I'm trying to... Uh-oh.
Shit. I thought Frank sorted the alarms. I'll bring the van round. You're gonna have to shoot your way out.
Okay. I'm literally standing up to do this. And ducking behind cover.
Take him out. Grab some.
Alright. There's another guy. There's another bitch in there. Oh! You want it? Whoa! Whoa, shit. Surely I'm just about out of bullets by now. Okay. Guy up top is getting me. Where the fuck am I getting shot from? It is a guy up top. Pop your head back up again, bitch. Okay. Whoa. Guess I may not must not be out yet. Oh, okay, that was weird. So, I'm leaning like this to do it on this simulated desk, and I try to lean and put my elbow on it to brace myself to turn, and that's when my brain realizes, oh yeah, there's not an actual desk here. That was freaking crazy. Get your ass back out here, come on. Shoot the clock? Nope. Okay. Ah, there we go.
Grab Serena and let's get out of
here. Got it. They shot it and it opened. All right, that was pretty sweet. I'll give it that. Okay, sitting back down again.
Playtime's over.
Oh,
mate, you're a legend. You lit that place up like a fucking Christmas tree. You're one ruthless little bastard. I'm proud of you.
Not only ruthless, I'm ruthless. Ruthless is like when you just had like a tornado that pulled something off your house, right? Oh, here we go.
Oi. Your eyes peeled.
Yeah. Alright, plenty of those. That's cool. Nice interactivity there.
Love it. That stuff's the dog's bollocks.
Okay, just wonder if I could grab something with her. Where's my gun at? Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Okay, that is awesome. Uh-oh. Being shot at. Fucking shit is right. You got a gun? Oh, damn. Bye. Oh, this is nicely immersive. And no control, it's on rails.
No planes,
meaning probably less simulation sickness.
Here, make yourself useful.
And these guys take a lot of bullets before they die. They must be video game characters. Get the fuck out of here. Whoa. Oh, my bad. Duck your damn head. He just called me a twat. He did. He just called me a twat. Can't believe he just called me a twat, you twit. Alright, you said that already, so... Duh, you think? Oh, this is incredible. Shit. Like, I'm ducking and bobbing and I wonder if I can be like... Ah, missed him. Except I am getting my ass kicked. Feels like, yep, I'm gonna die. Did I die or did I get him? Well, I heard a bling like I just got a... What? What? Okay. Is that a loading screen? No, that was me dying. Okay. Jackass. Have one of these ready to go. Give me the driver. Can I hit the tires? He's gonna come around this side. Oh, I can even hang out the window. Shit. douche. Problem is, you can't reload until you're totally out of bullets. My tendency on first-person shooter games is to reload whenever opportunity presents itself instead. There you go. Yeah, I'm gonna die again. I can feel it. Oh shit. I can switch hands. Ah, dead again. Whew. Okay. Can't interact with that at all. Whew. Very, very warm. Oh, shit. Shit, let it go. Pick it up a different way. There we go. That works better. Oh, I just shot my drink. Ah! Threw it out the window. Whoa! Okay, take out the driver first and you're good. Makes logical sense. I was taking out the threats as they happened. I'm shot at, I'm not sure what side. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, we're in the UK or something. I need to shoot the guy in the right hand to get the driver. Oh, for real? Shit, really? That's not doing me any good. Fucking load. Whoa. Driver? I hit him, I don't think I killed him. Is he coming around the back? Ah, motorcycle. Shit. Suck it, you bastard. Bye-bye. Woo!
Fucking see that? Did you fucking see that? That was fucking amazing. Huh. Fuck me.
Cheers.
That was close. A bit too fucking close.
The fucking alarms are... Something don't feel right. It just don't fucking feel right. Frank said he had those alarms sorted 100%.
Frank's a dick.
He fucking lied to us. He's clearing ranks. Look what happened to French Tony. He's fucking mugging us off. He never thought we'd get the diamond. He thought we'd be fucking dead by now.
Okay.
Fuck.
Because the car is rocking a little, that's a little disconcerting.
Serena.
Kill the bastard.
We got Frank's beloved Serena. And he wants her.
Right.
So when he comes to get her...
Okay, the fact that this car is rocking a little is kind of wigging my senses out. All that motion didn't, but the rocking does. Okay, I'm going to have to call it quits for this one. Okay. East London lockup. Press start. Whew! Okay, that was something special right there. Holy crap. I would argue that is even more immersive than the Batman one. That London heist is a friggin' thing to behold. So let me swap out of my controls here and give you some sort of last thoughts before I wrap this particular stream up and turn the fan on before doing another stream that deals with Eve. Pardon me, reaching down and grab my controller right here. So, VR Luge, meh. Not a lot of motion sickness, simulation sickness kind of stuff, but at the same time, kind of basic. And not a big fan of the way the graphics work on this one. Scavenger's Oddyssey looked decent enough. Got a little bit towards the queasiness area. Just kind of jumped out of there before we got too far into it. But looks like kind of an interesting combination of like an Eve and a Riggs kind of thing. Or a Valkyrie and Riggs kind of thing. Ocean Descent, cool. Swoosh. But at the same... I was curious if I could do that. At the same time, all you're doing is really looking around. So the sense of danger is kind of meh. Danger Ball, speaking of danger, pretty sweet. Up, and I swung at it with my free hand instead of the one with the controller, so it didn't go anywhere. Damn. Sorry! But I actually kind of like this. Pretty simple, but yet pretty neat. Nice and energetic kind of feel. Really gives you a sense of what the headset can do as far as tracking your head movements. And London Heist, holy shit, is all I got to say. That was fantastic. The immersion of holding the gun, the interacting with the items, being able to look behind me in the truck to see who was coming and follow the guy when he was flying. That was fantastic. So PSVR Worlds is a $40 game. I would suggest that for maybe Scavenger's Oddyssey, but definitely Danger Ball and London Heist, it's certainly worth... I'm trying to make a mental comparison here to something that's relatively short yet cool and immersive, like I guess Batman VR, Batman Arkham VR. I would say that this is definitely worth maybe $20. Definitely worth bothering to get from... Just fucking around. Definitely cool to get within that launch bundle, which I did not, by the way. Not sure if a $40 price tag... Shit. My bad. Not sure if a $40 price tag is enough. Or if there's enough here to justify the $40 price tag. But I don't know. I mean, this feels like this is definitely what they intended it to be, which is sort of the demo quality presentation. I was thinking that really Batman Arkham VR is a great demo quality immersive experience to show people, but I gotta say, now that we got London Heist on here, this may be the most demo worthy thing, which makes sense given the fact that it is essentially a series of smaller scenarios designed to show off what it can do beyond the regular demo disc that does come with the unit, even in the base mode. So again, this has been Nathan B. Butler. This is my channel. Again, check out stuff here like Battlefront live streams, Let's Plays, of Disney Infinity 3.0 Star Wars playsets, Let's Plays of Star Wars, Lego Star Wars The Force Awakens, lots of other reviews for Fantasy Flight Games, Star Wars materials from the Star Wars Home Video Library, tons of stuff on here. I'm also on Cloud City Casino and Star Wars Beyond the Films, two podcasts you can find on StarWarsReport.com. We'll be doing a review and discussion of PlayStation VR in a very near-term episode here very soon of Cloud City Casino, because that is a Star Wars and more gaming podcast, both tabletop and video games. So, before I screw around too much with this danger ball, I will bid you adieu. I'm going to take a little bit of a break, get the air conditioner going a little bit, and then we'll probably be diving back in for at least a little bit of maybe the demo disc, maybe Eve Gunjack, maybe Eve Valkyrie, but definitely a little more streaming this evening. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.